can't see a thing. I can't tell who's who.
Nor do I.
Oh, I know that. I just can't tell who's who of the girls.
Thank you.
you. four, three, two, one. You're on.
Hello, and welcome to WKCJ. I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Kim. Today's forecast is partly cloudy with a 50% chance of rain. The lows being in the 20s and the highs being in the upper 30s. It's going to be a chilly one today, so be sure to wear those coats. Cheryl?
Thanks, Kim. Our top story today, a terrible tragedy, that is of two deaths in Verona. Was it because of love or hate? We'll turn live now to Caroline Prather, interviewing Lady Capulet in Verona. Caroline?
Thanks, Cheryl. Let's get right to it. Many things to blame for the death of your daughter, Juliet.
I have only one thing to blame, and that is the hatred between the Montagues and I know.
Juliet would have told you about her love for Romeo. Would that have changed things?
I would like to say yes, I would. But I'm afraid the answer must be no. But my husband would have told her, because Romeo is a Montague.
What's going to happen now between the Capulets and your enemies, the Montagues?
Well, we just have our family together as friends. They're all our enemies. But I wish it would have happened in a different way.
Now back to you, Cheryl.
That's all for today's news. Have a nice day.
We have to do it over.
Okay, come on, start.
Wait till you
wait. Dead. My dad started ready.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're on.
Hello, and welcome to WKCJ. I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Kim. Today's forecast is partly cloudy with a 50% chance of rain. The lowest being in the 20s, and I can't do it.
I know, I can't.
Steer clear.
I'm sorry, that was my fault.
Five, four, three, two, one. You're on.
Hello, and welcome to WKCJ. I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Kim.
Cheryl, and then I'll pass it, and okay. That's when you go, and I'm...
Yeah! Sorry.
Would you like me to begin, Dad?
You want me to do the dun-dun-dun stuff for you?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're on.
Hello, and welcome to WKCJ. I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Kim. Today's forecast is partly cloudy with a 50% chance of rain. The lowest being in the 20s and the highest being in the upper 30s. It's going to be a chilly.
Our top story today, a terrible tragedy, that is of two deaths in Verona. Was it because of love or hate? We'll turn live now to Caroline Prather, interviewing Lady Capulet in Verona. Caroline?
Thanks, Cheryl. Let's get right to it. Who do you think is to blame for the death of your daughter, Juliet?
I have only one thing to blame. And that is the hatred between the Montagues and I know.
Juliet would have told you about her love for Romeo. Would that have changed things?
I would like to say yes, I would. But I'm afraid the answer must be no. But my husband would have told her, because Romeo is a Montague.
What's going to happen now between the Capulets and your enemies, the Montagues?
Well, we just have our family together as friends. They're all our enemies. But I wish it would have happened in a different way.
Now back to you, Cheryl.
And that's all for today's news.
One more.
This time will be perfect. Okay, I promise.
Dad, don't record over this one, just in case this one's any bad and Cheryl's mom comes. Any worse.
I've saved all.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're on.
Hello, and welcome to WKCJ. I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Kim. Today's forecast is a partly cloudy with a 50% chance of rain. The lows being in the 20s and the highs being in the upper 30s. It's going to be a chilly one today, so make sure you wear those coats. Cheryl?
Thanks, Kim. Our top story today, a terrible tragedy that is of two deaths in Verona. Was it because of love or hate? We'll turn live now to Caroline Prater interviewing Lady Capulet in Verona. Caroline?
Thanks, Cheryl. Let's get right to it. Who do you think is to blame for the death of your daughter, Juliet?
I have only one thing to blame, and that is our hatred between the Montagues and myself.
Juliet would have told you about her life for Romeo, but that would have changed things.
I would like to say yes, I would. And I'm afraid the answer must be no, but my husband would have told her, because Romeo is a Montague.
What's going to happen now between the Capulets and your enemies, the Montagues?
Well, the death has brought our family together as friends, no longer enemies. But I wish it could happen in a different way.
now back to you, Cheryl.
And that's all for today's news.
Have a nice day.
Cut.
I couldn't hear you.
I like your nose blowing the best.
You like your nose blowing the best?
It's 8:15.
I like the hair.
Be home like
9:45. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're on.
Hello. And welcome to WKCJ. I'm Cheryl.
And I'm Kim. Today's forecast is partly cloudy with a 50% chance of rain, the lows being in the 20s and the highs being in the upper 30s. It's going to be a chilly one today, so be sure to wear those coats.
Cheryl? Thanks, Kim. Our top story today, a terrible tragedy that is of two deaths in Verona. Was it because of love or hate? We'll all turn live now to Caroline Prather interviewing Lady Capulet in Verona. Caroline?
Thanks, Cheryl. Let's get right to it. Who do you think is to blame for the death of your daughter, Juliet?
I have only one thing to blame, and that is our hatred between the Montagues and myself.
Juliet would have told you about her life for Romeo, but that would have changed things.
I would like to say yes, I would. And I'm afraid the answer must be no, but my husband would have told her, because Romeo was a Montague.
What's going to happen now between the Capulets and your enemies, the Montagues?
Well, the death has brought our family together as friends, no longer enemies.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride a one-horse open sleigh. in the stupid Christmas t-shirts that she made us all get. This isn't the cheesiest Christmas family. I don't know what is. Check out Misty's got one. Everyone's got one.
What is she taking that for?
Here's Grandma's dog. Here's Kim in a stupid shirt. Alright, I'm wearing one too. Of our stock. Blank tapes, socks, scoopies, film, and a nail kit that she forgot to put into our stocking last year, which we don't need because we've all got a new one since. My stuff right now so my sisters can't steal it and say it was theirs. Black brush, red socks, white socks, crazy color socks, and two blank tapes, and Mom! Tries to be funny. Your mom for Christmas.
2 hours ago.
Christmas, 1991.
What the hell is that?
Merry Christmas.
Shut up, I was falling.
Look anxious. Everybody look excited.
Yay.
Bite your nails. There's the back of Brooke's head. And who's this? Fluffy!
Woo!
Where's Florence? Probably washing her hands after cleaning up our whole kitchen. Hey, we're ready for the big moment. Yay, the money comes to me.
We're
gonna open up the mystery gift here from Pop Pop to Dad.
Is that the winner? Is that the winner?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey,
Lucky.
Lucky, you can't take the orange
out. Flip it
over. No,
flip it.
Wait a minute, you got something. Flip this, got something. Can't tell you. Get the envelope, Sharon.
Right here.
You got the envelope.
Yeah.
I don't know, I think I...
Huh. Ouch.
What? I think I taped it up.
What a violent man.
We'll go get a knife.
Yeah.
Whatever it is, it's awful heavy and compact because Mercy is small and it's that heavy. Back up, Brooke. It's heavy paper.
Get all these back.
Good grief, Paul. Now we know why you're saving up.
Now we know why you said it's recyclable.
Kim's. Kim's the winner.
Yes. What is it? A workman's vice, but I put down.
My money! My money!
Kim!
Where's the money? No care! She had a detective helping her!
Where's the money at? I mean...
I'm glued here.
Now y'all appreciate all my different types of ribbons on here. I think it's Kim.
Somebody has to move. Sharon, he said, did you want to save the bows?
Yeah.
Yeah, we may as well.
These are nice bows.
Ready?
Ones.
Where's ready? Kim? Where? Oh, there she is under there. Here we go. Okay, there we go. Who's the dumb blonde over there?
Act like a bunch of squirrels now. Everybody take his little pile and run it for
her. Are you ready? Can I open this?
Okay, open their envelopes. Wait,
which one are you opening? The one from Red Bow.
I guess this can.
You know what it is, girls?
Eckerd's.
Eckerd's.
It's an Eckerd's gift certificate for makeup.
Oh, mine's not.
Well, that yours, you didn't open the one for me.
Oh.
Who's this from?
Nearby, probably.
Yeah, no, it just says Kristen.
Is it $10 in there?
I have 20.
20, that's from?
I have one that just says Brooke. I have another one.
It's over for Heather last night for 4 hours. What a great friend am I. Isn't that gorgeous?
Too bad she doesn't have any better looking friends to put pictures of in there.
Turn the power off. Christmas Day. Let's see what Heather got.
Merry Christmas. Hey, you're not wearing scum clothes.
Oh, like I look gross.
Can you tell? Doesn't it look like him?
They all buy things that they want to wear.
I picked up these shorts because I like them.
Cute, yeah. Can't film and look at it.
Remember how I wanted them?
We each got one of those.
Off-white or forest green?
I got off-white forest green in this color.
Wow.
And I got that color.
Oh, cute bra.
I'm taking that back.
You can't film and watch.
I got a pink one too. This one's kind of...
Try to film. Look, Heather got the purse I wanted from the guy.
Oh, I told my mom 50 times I wanted this.
Oh, it's so cute.
So you can open yours first?
I can't walk anywhere. I'm afraid I'm going to step on something.
I think I've just taken the lid off.
I'm done.
You can just take the lid off, too.
Oh, cute!
Oh, I like these.
This is cool.
These are cool. They're not crooked, either.
Aren't they cool? I saw this and I was like... Look at that.
Yes, I love that.
I'm so glad.
So
you don't know. And feel it.
Oh,
I tried it on.
Gosh, this
I tried
looks
it
so
on
good.
And I was like, oh, I love this. I got you something else too. I gotta find it. I didn't know if I was gonna go to your house to open these or not. Hold on.
This is so nice, Heather. I'm glad. I was hoping maybe you got me some pajamas like Mary.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. Oh,
it
fell back here somewhere.
Remember how we were talking about, going on buying sexy things? No, it's tied up. I was like, this is really
great. Yes, I made it.
Oh, I love this.
It took me so long.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, but I liked it too. See, this is wrapping paper. And then I got the frame. Because they didn't have any of those mats that I usually get. And besides, they were ugly anyway.
This is
Amy Alston's house on Christmas Day. Huh?
Is that a new one?
No, it's the same one.
It looks different. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
You know, at least cycle for Christmas. She already's driving it.
McDonald's.
The Edith house? They are not expecting us. This should be kind of crazy.
Wait.
Christmas! We've come to film you and your presents.
Up. No, come on in.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, good looking.
Hey, Kristen. Did Kristen call you?
Merry Christmas, ooh, Kristen!
Table food they ate.
We're talking to my son on the telephone.
No.
My new shoes. Hi,
kid. Did you guys get...
Tarek. Merry Christmas. Friend. I know, isn't that crazy?
Fortune carrot. I bet there's people
like us. Oh, it's focusing. That's pretty.
Wow.
Heather, thanks.
I got earrings from like Buena Vista.
Just show them with
this
your ring.
Not focusing.
Beautiful.
And she's wearing red for Christmas. I had Christmas box.
This is my little creation.
You made that?
Yes.
Wow.
I made a bunch of them.
Oh, great. My mom's going to see this and call you up. Make me some.
Santa Claus has a little red nose and little eyes. And this is a napkin. You take the napkin out and it becomes a napkin. And then you take
it. Oh. Yes. Did you make it?
Yeah. It's got the plaid under on the inside. Hello.
Oh, get away, girl. Hello.
Your house looks so pretty.
Don't you just love it?
I was thinking, I'm like, oh, I hope they're done opening presents and they don't remember. Oh, never mind. They're
all
kids.
Take me! Hello. Hi.
Who's the ham? Hi, Hildegard.
My name's not Hildegard. She thinks my name's Hildegard, Mommy. She does.
I opened the door to this.
Come here.
No, Emily, you can't go in there. It's forbidden to
take me. She's taking my voice.
Right. Oh, man. I mean, when I call now, I'm going to have to listen to you.
Yeah.
Please do it. Do you see?
Hello.
All right.
This bracelet from my mom's.
Hey, you like this, don't you?
Okay, guys,
your Christmas. Heather, you want some R&B?
Oh, wow. Look at Erica's Christmas present.
Yeah, okay. I'll bring the crackers.
Hello, I'm Erica Donald.
I remember when they rezoned us, they all sat.
Kristen, don't waste the batteries.
Now everybody knows I'm Erica's sister. Like, die, I want enough.
And I'm
from Kansas City, and I'm on TV 18.
Look at the camera.
Let's just do it again.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, my name's Emily Diamond, and I'm Erica Diamond's sister.
You don't have to say that part.
And she's from OHS school, and I'm from Kissimmee, and I'm on TV 18.
Are you going to go apply for a job and say, hi, I'm Emily, Erica's sister?
Probably.
Well,
hey guys, where are you going?
Where's Mountain Top?
Kim. Hey. I can't see where I'm walking.
Hi.
Is Kristen in here?
Kristen who? She doesn't live here anymore.
Oh, she doesn't?
No, she died.
She ran away.
She died too.
Is that don't Kristen Astin? You look so beautiful. What are you wearing?
It's cute. I think it's cute.
I'm so sick. I'm sleeping till my phone comes like dinner. I'm like.
Got a Game Boy?
No, it's my dad's. He got some new games. So I'm playing.
What does your shirt say? Turn around. Turn around, Kristen. Hold on. No, wait. I gotta get close up. Okay.
Where's my ring?
Oh, wow.
Well, let me see that.
They made you nail polish.
And Bojela's.
Stop moving. The lipstick. My dad's like, she's not
it's
in the
living room. Because
I'm going, if it's for me, I'm not here. my room. Stop it, Heather.
Hi guys!
Hi!
How are you?
Welcome back to our room. It's the family!
Oh. Hi, how are you guys doing?
Hi.
Kristen, get them something to drink and there's some Christmas cookies and things. You guys in here.
There's a CD player.
What'd you have?
It's a black. Oh my gosh, this is like blush for me.
What?
This base. I mean, this compact, whatever it is. Watch this.
Yeah.
Let me see how they're turned. Yes.
This is my stereo, all complete and new for Christmas. Here you go with the speakers. There you go.
Over my part.
Oh, how to play?
That's what I'm doing right now.
Don't, Kristen.
I don't want that on there.
Oh, but it's a scream.
Like, I don't want anybody in the world to ever see that.
If you left out all of this stuff, it would have been
right. No way.
Let's study.
Joy.
I guess I should go get them now. And then you can be making them all off. Now you know, anytime you bake cookies, there's supposed to be a decent turn way up. Then we're at that. But you have to, after you take that batch of cookies out, and time every one up for 10 minutes so that you don't forget about them. After you take them out, leave them out for a minute and turn it back up to 400 so they're running.
That's what I'm doing next year.
Mom, go get my camera!
I'm going to check this year.
And then the next year is the cheerleading. So you get to put the other pot in that it needs to be. So that it won't turn it down to acid.
Yeah, but
you burn them anyway!
Well, are you going to church tonight? Where's he going?
And yeah.
Well, since we're supposed to be studying, we just got to save you our coats.
Are those your black shoes, Kim? Yeah.
No.
I wonder.
I have Spanish and chemistry.
Well, you have to study. I brought the phone there.
Huh? Oh, Arto.
Build a beautiful new home on your property up to 90% complete. Select from only 30 months.